Boosting communities now prohibited in World of Warcraft. What last night was only a rumor and a lie turned out to be true. Well, how about that? Blizzard has published a blue post about boosting communities now being prohibited in World of Warcraft. Added Blizzard clarifications. This change does not prohibit the practice of boosting. Guilds can still sell carries. It only prohibits the organization of boosting communities, especially those operating on multiple realms. According to Blizzard, the policy is aimed to crack down on middleman entries that profit off purely linking boosters to players. Okay.
Ding dong!
I bet that the reason why Blizzard is doing this is because they're tired of not making money off of those motherfuckers. That's my first guess.
Okay. Basically, these boosting communities have just gotten bigger and bigger and bigger over the years. This has gotten massive now, where they're sponsoring, like, for example, like Cody, I think, has a sponsorship from one of the boosting communities, and they literally just give away free boost to him and, like, people in his community, and all they ask is you just put the thing on the screen. So these boosting communities...
Hold on, whoa, slow down. I'm gonna ask you guys a very obvious question. Before I ask it, I want you guys to know, I do not play WoW. This comes from my ignorance. Okay, here's my question. Is Blizzard totally okay with people advertising third sites, real money trading, and I guess real money like boosting services in the sense that, hey, I will level your character for you, give me money. They're not okay with that. Okay. Well, then what is the boosting community? What is that? Boosting is for gold. Okay.
These are getting massive. They're becoming super popular. And it becomes a thing where this is now, it's no longer a community. This is an industry. And this industry is built around devaluing the accomplishments of the average player. And I think that Blizzard, in a lot of ways, the boosting communities, we have trading cartels in the game. We've got the Goblin trading cartels and the Ethereal trading cartels. It's not that trading cartels are not part of the WoW lore. They actually really are. And I think boosting communities, in many regards, holy shit. Okay, I think boosts are, is somebody on a... You know that guy is like probably like 58 years old. He's got a beard down to here. He's got a big old fucking belly. He's wearing a bandana to cover his balding head. Imagine, I know. And he's riding a Harley where you have to put your arms up like this.
Hell yeah.
You know? And he's still
got his brother
shirt on from whenever he saw him in concert back in 1974. All right, so original post. Pretty small post. As the conditions change by which various entities operate in World of Warcraft, we are compelled to update our policies to further our goal of making the gameplay experience as fair and welcoming as possible. So basically what they're saying is, we didn't want to do this bullshit, but because y'all wanted to play around, here it is. That's what it is, and you know it. Since we last updated our policies, we found that an increasing disturbance of gameplay experience has been caused by organizations excessively advertising various non-traditional services in-game. Non-traditional services. Blizzard, who are you talking to? Who are you talking to? Non-traditional services? You mean boosting? Shut up. Everybody knows what you're saying. Just use the word. As of today, we will prohibit organizations to offer boosting, matchmaking.
So you buy the WoW token. How much is the WoW token? $20?
I'm a new waiter. I want to wade. I buy token. $20.
Now I can sell that token in-game. That's fucking ridiculous. So then I sell the token in-game. I sell it for gold. Or can I give the token for a carry? Can I do that? I can't. Gold only. Oh, it's only sellable on the auction house. Okay. So then, what if one token isn't enough for the amount of carries that I want to get? So then I buy another one. Can I buy another one? I can buy another one. Let's say that I have unlimited money. Can I buy unlimited tokens? Ooh. Okay. How much gold does a WoW token go for? Depends on server, of course. Just give me like a rough average. Well, let's do 200 because it's $20, 200. So that means that for every 400K gold, I have to spend $40. Holy shit, $40. 50 tokens is $1,000. Obviously, that's a lot of money. So Blizzard is cracking down on the boosting community, the people that take that money and carry the person, only the middleman. The issue is Blizzard has is that these communities also work RMT and RMT. All right. That's what I was getting to. Okay, thank you. So me being a new waiter, I want to get carried. So I buy the token. Let's say I buy 5 tokens. And then I'm like, oh, what the fuck am I doing? It's cheaper on this RMT website. What the fuck? I'm never buying this token again. Why would I buy this fucking piece of shit token when I could just buy it off this website? Because it's not safe. I mean, I disagree with that. Not that I would know, but I disagree with that. Now Baldi understands why Blizzard bans it. So Blizzard is pissed that gold sellers are selling gold that is cheaper than what the token is. So basically people, if they want gold, they don't buy the token to sell it on the auction house. They just straight buy the gold from an RMT. That the gist of it. That's why Blizzard's butthurt. Yeah, because buying the tokens is even a bigger waste and they don't like that. They want you to buy their tokens. Okay.
Escrow or other non-traditional services, including those offered for gold. And I want to emphasize the word organizations. They are prohibiting organizations from doing this. They are not prohibiting everybody from doing this. So boosting in your guild with your friends is still totally fucking fine. This is completely okay. It's not a big deal. The only thing that's not okay is when you're doing it with this massive thing and everybody is like making gold cross server. So there's the organizations that are getting fucked, not the individual players. If that makes
sense. And the reason why the organizations are getting fucked is because Blizzard wants that money that's going to them.
Makes sense, or being disallowed.
I just have a question here. Why does anyone play this game?
So you can still sell boosts on your server, your guild can still sell Mythic Sylvanas, all of that stuff is completely still intact, okay? World of Warcraft accounts found to be in violation of this policy are subject to account actions. These actions can include warning, account suspensions, and if necessary, permanent closure of the disruptive World of Warcraft accounts. Organizations operating across multiple realms and excessively advertising traditional in-game sales are contrary to the terms and conditions of Blizzard's EULA. So what they're really saying is that, like, I think people don't really understand, like, how hard Blizzard can fuck these communities if they want to. Like, they can fuck them in so many different ways, you have no idea. And, like, I am not a corporate lawyer. As you guys know, I was going to go to law school. I dropped out to make videos about World of Warcraft. Again, a very hard sell for my father. However, I do have a general understanding of this. And all I can tell you is that they can completely shut this down.
Yeah, that's really ironic, actually, man. Because for how shit WoW is, it was one of the best decisions he ever made in his life. It's kind of ironic.
Like, Blizzard can 110% shut this down completely. And this is just, it's just, that's what they can do. The truth is that, again, this is something that is harmful to the average player. I think that it has become increasingly more harmful.
Why in the mother of fuck can you buy the WoW token and then sell it? Why? It should not be sellable. The entire point is being sellable. Let me rephrase my question. In what world is it not going to be abused and fuck everything up? No world. Okay. New world. Yo, New World wishes it had this problem. New World wishes it had this problem, dude. Look, I know, obviously, yes, it's about the money. Yeah, I know that. I get it. I've played other games with that stuff, too. So, yeah. So, my question was, if they put this type of system in the game, how was it not going to be completely fucked? The answer is, it was going to be completely fucked.
It's something that as soon as people realized they could do it, it just kind of escalated. It got worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. It's like, imagine what boosting would be like by the time the Dragon Isles expansion comes out, or whatever it's going to be. Imagine, like, by the time the next expansion comes out, imagine how defined and formulaic boosting would be. It would just be complete fucking garbage. So, yeah. All right, let's go over here. Policy update does not restrict individuals or guilds from using the provided in-game tools. Trade channel. to buy or sell in-game items or activities for in-game currency. However, boosting communities, especially those who operate across multiple realms.
They are specifically targeting people. Here's the deal. Activision Blizzard pumped mobile game mechanics into WoW hard 2 expansions ago. You can convert in-game currency to Blizzard balance at $15 per 200K. So the buyer spends $20 per 200K. Even if they convert, Blizzard clears 25% profit.
Realms are no longer permitted. We urge all such organizations to cease doing business in World of Warcraft immediately in order to maintain uninterrupted access to the game. Bro, like, that's actually, like, damn, bro. Like, you know that the person that wrote this fucking doesn't like these guys. You know they don't like these guys. Because, like, they get to, like, that's, like, some fucking, that's, like, some dystopian thing where it's, like, please, please return to your houses so you will not be subject to, disintegration. You know what I mean? Like, it's just, it's so fucking just passively aggressive. It's so fucking passively aggressive. I love it. I absolutely fucking love it. Now, there were a couple of people who asked clarifying questions, and we're going to look at that right now. I believe cross-realm boosting is disallowed unless I read it wrong. Organizations, this is what Blizzard said again. This is as a response to somebody who said, again, I believe cross-realm boosting is disallowed unless I read it wrong. Organizations who disruptively advertise across all realms and establish escrow services are the primary target of this policy update. Guilds and individuals who are inviting players from another realm to join them in traditional game activities in exchange for gold are allowed as they were before. So really what Blizzard is saying is, like, this is pretty much just about the boosting communities and everything else is, like, whatever. And I think it's, again, Blizzard is doing the smart thing. They are making a small change, and they are saying, well, not small, it depends on, like, how small you want to call this, but they are making a change. They're like, let's see what happens, and then after they see what happens, then they'll probably adjust more if they have to or not. It's very massive. Yeah, I mean, for a lot of people it is. Would that include GDKP runs, where players benefit financially off of other people? I don't think so, but let's see what Blizzard says. That depends on the definition of financially. Okay, so Ian wrote this post. Or it was either him or Bill Clinton. It means an exchange of gold only without a middleman entity. Then it sounds the same as sort of gold activities the players have been enjoying for 17 years, which are not the focus of this policy update. So what they're really saying here is that anybody who, like, all of the normal stuff that doesn't have to do with one of these boosting communities you can do are just totally fine. So let's go ahead and read. Almost fell down here.
I gotta get me a bell. Ding dong. So they actually don't give a shit about boosting. They just care about the big organizations because they're stealing their money. Someone else mentioned that people wanted those boosting communities gone for years. So it is a good PR move. So it seems to me like it's two birds with one stone. And let me explain. So if you ban these communities, then it's more money for Blizzard. And if you ban these communities, it makes you look like the good guy. When in reality, you kind of don't give a shit. But if it makes you look like the good guy, then why not do it? Really, the fact that they've been around for so long is kind of perplexing. Because Blizzard could have gained some better PR and they could have probably got more money too. Like, I'm not saying that this is going to totally kill RMT. It's not. You can never kill RMT. This is just going to destroy it in game, right? Like, it's not going to really affect too much outside of game, correct? If Microsoft got wind of those communities being bad PR, they might give a shit.
Let's go ahead and read some comments and some opinions from people. So let me actually move up for you guys a little bit more. There we go. All right. So, what do you guys think? I think this is a good thing.
Yeah, behind the scene influence, that's what I'm thinking about.
These are breeding grounds for corruption and RMT. It's one of those things, it's like, lead me not into temptation. I know there's going to be people from these communities that are going to say, but we was the one that didn't do it. Everybody else did it. Except us. So why we get punished? And that's what they're all going to say. Yeah, that's what they're all going to say. Isn't that interesting? So yeah, there you go. Am I wrong to think this displays their confidence in 10.0? I really thought they would hold out on this change until then. You know what my opinion is, Nixie? I think it's because they couldn't. I think it's getting so bad now that it's impossible to ignore it. Like, we can't hold off in 10.0. It's not that they were so confident in it. They were like, this is so bad. Like, we have to do something right now. Like, we have to stem the bleeding. So,
again, I don't play WoW, but it seems to me like WoW's RMT cell chat boosting is as bad as a fucking Korean game. No, but close. Close to it. So I at least have the right mindset. Is it like Ion bad? Because holy fuck. Imagine 6 out of 10 Party Finder listings are boosting services.
That's what I think. Maybe it's a little bit of both. Hopefully it's a little bit of both. Why are Boosty Boys banned? Because because they're fucking RMTing and everybody knows it. Everybody fucking knows it. You know it. I know it. Everybody knows it. And fucking, you know, as I said, this is what every boosting community is going to say. Well, this is fucked up. I can't believe they would target all of us. Especially us. Because we was the only ones that wasn't doing it. Everybody else was doing it, but not us. Why punish us? And that's what every single one is going to say. You see what I mean? Every single one is going to say that.
How much is this actually going to affect the game? Very little. Besides chat and being flooded, will this actually stop any activity? Because I don't think that this is going to stop any activity whatso-fucking-ever. I'll just
make sure.
Isn't that
interesting? Boosting allowed, Blizzard does it. Yeah, the only boosting that will be allowed is whenever Blizzard does it themselves. That's right. Let's see what happens whenever the new expansion comes out. Because let's be honest, we all know that the new expansion, it's going to come out, and there's going to be a new system that nobody wants. Nobody wants it.
The damage has already been done, right? Like, everybody already knows about, like, the websites, the Discords, all of that shit, right? So instead of just advertising in-game, they're just going to advertise in their Discord, which they probably already do anyway, right? All Discord communities close their activities.
I don't believe that. I don't believe that, man. I just don't. That just sounds so so unrealistic to me.
Lemon Max said it won't affect their sales because the name is already so big, but it might affect new people.
Dude, look how I paused.
I didn't mean to pause them like that.
But we're getting it. And there's going to be a thing with this system that's like, it's like you build a house. You build a whole house. It's done. And there's no front door. You talk to the foreman. You say, man, how about a front door? Foreman says, no, we can't have a front door. I say, why not? Well, it's going to create wind currents in the house, and it's going to cool the house. It's going to allow you to become one with nature and one with your environment. It's going to promote inclusiveness and community around with the people that you want. And you're like, bro, I just want a front door for my house. He says, sorry. If we added a front door to this house, would it even be a house anymore? So you move into the house, and you don't have your front door. And then, 3 months later, the foreman comes back, and he says, so yeah, we're thinking about putting a front door into your house. I thought it was the right decision. And you're like, really? You're like, yeah, how'd you come to that? Well, that's what you said. Why'd it take you 3 months? All right, I gotta go. Door's up. See ya. That's been the way that WoW has been developed, is we're getting houses built without a front door. So there's going to be like this obvious solution to the new system that Blizzard will probably like, oh, no, we can't do that. We can't do that. And what we're going to do is, if they don't change this shit before it goes out on release, oh, you play it, it'll be great. Yeah, just like Azeroth gear, right? If they do that, then we'd know that they did not learn their lesson, and it's better to just kind of keep playing other games. That's the truth. Why?
I have learned more about WoW not playing it and just hearing so many opinions, so many point of views, so many people complain, so many issues with this fucking game. I have learned so much about this game.
I get fucked around. Why spend a second of your time getting fucked around? You think you do, but you don't want it. You think you want the front door. But you don't. Yeah, true. The next time Blizzard will really have an opportunity to let people down again will be the next expansion. some people will come back to not WoW for 9.2, but the next time Blizzard will really have a chance to fucking let everybody down again, it's going to be the next expansion. And yeah, I'm going to buy it. A lot of you guys are probably going to buy it. If for anything else than just the fucking stupid ass, this stupid shit that's going to happen, because it's just going to be funny. It's like playing New World. Like, you cannot truly enjoy New World unless you include the duping and the boosting and the fucking account sharing and the botting and the cheating as part of the entertainment of the game. Mike, you borrowed a tweet from a few months back. 1 second. Shows that it's just communities and not individual guilds. Good for the game long term. Yeah, I'm not really sure if I agree with banning boosting entirely. I think that I kind of don't agree with it. But with the WoW token, it's just like, what's the difference in boosting an RMT? I mean, and buying and pay to win. I mean, like, it's really kind of hard to say that there is one, isn't there? So
the fact that you can buy that token and then sell it for gold, that's literally RMT. Literally RMT. Let's say you're allowed to buy game time with your currency in the game. I actually think that's okay. Basically, you can pay your sub with your character. But the fact that you can buy the token and then sell it in game, that's just literally RMT.
Well, I don't know, man. Like, but I think this is a good first step. Can boosting communities not just split into multiple boosting guilds and continue doing the same shit? I think that many of them will probably do something similar to that. I think what they're really trying to cut down on is the industry of it, if that makes sense. Remove WoW token for real money.
True.
There's going to be the same, if not more, spam and trade chat now. Yes, there will be. There will be a lot more spam and trade chat. I think that they should probably find a way to... what they could do is they could just say, like, you can't advertise it in-game. It's kind of like how in Final Fantasy you can't advertise add-ons in-game. And they could just make that same general policy... For...
Whoa. Are you saying that there's add-ons in my game? This dude's saying there's add-ons in my game? Yo, this isn't WoW, bro. This isn't WoW, bro. We don't use add-ons. We don't use any of those, that cheater shit. Okay? Come on.
I could make that same general policy for boosting in WoW. I'm not sure. Or make it a new channel. Yeah, there's that too. Make it, or something like join boosting. Yeah, exactly. Boosting for WoW tokens has to go. It means both the game is pay to win. Listen, man, the way I look at things is it's important to take W's when you can take a W, and that doesn't mean that it's the only W you ever want. I agree with you completely, but that doesn't mean that this isn't a good first step, and it isn't a solution to a problem that a lot of people have had. So yeah, I'm glad that this has happened.
I don't think this is coming from a good place. Correct me if I'm wrong, but couldn't they have done this for fucking years? This leads me to believe that this is coming from a place of desperation. This is all PR. They don't actually care about the players. While this is a step in the right direction, I don't think that this is intended to be followed up with another wholesome step. They're only going to care when they're in like a certain situation. I'm an outsider and I'm ignorant. That's why I'm asking so many questions. I'm just telling you guys what my initial impression of it is.
Is he talking about Game Pass? No. We're probably not going to get any news about Game Pass until probably the end of 2023. Yeah, the end of 2023. That's what I'm kind of expecting. After the acquisition is like pretty much solidified, then I think that we'll probably see something with Game Pass. Imagine if they did this 5 years ago. Well, they wouldn't have needed to do it 5 years ago. Here's the thing, is that doing it 5 years ago wasn't as necessary. There weren't as many boosting communities, and it wasn't as big of a deal. The reason they're doing it is because it's gotten a lot bigger, and that's why they're changing it.
That's where I don't know, dude. Like, I don't think that's why. I mean, maybe it could be. I just really don't think so. I don't think that they're doing it because it got this big. I think they're doing it to make themselves look better. You know what? I don't know. I'm probably wrong. I'm obviously way less knowledgeable than a lot of people, so.
Yeah, I mean, that's what it is. Rain low-key makes us chill. Yeah, man. I'm chilling. I'm fucking chilling. Wait, cross-faction raids and dungeons? Holy crap. It's a big day, boys. It's a big fucking day. It sounds like preparations for 10.0. Yeah, for sure. Let's see. Where's the rest of this? What do you think the chances acquisition doesn't go through? Oh, with Blizzard and Microsoft? Zero. I think that the truth is, like, as I said, Blizzard bought Microsoft, or sorry, Activision. Blizzard was bought on sale. Like, this is the basically, Microsoft bought a company that just got audited by the strictest government authority in the world. Probably not in the world, but in the U.S., is the government of California. So they just got a free audit that cleaned house of probably 99%, 95% of all the creeps and weirdos. They also are buying it at a massively depressed price because of all the controversies. They're buying it on the horizon of multiple game releases and also announcements like Diablo 4, Overwatch 2, new WoW expansion. They're basically buying it at its lowest possible value. So yeah, I mean, there's no way.
That's a lot of good points. I never really thought about it before, but they did get a free audit. They did clean house and they did buy it cheaper. That was a huge win.
No way this acquisition doesn't go through. Microsoft made a brilliant decision. It was actually like this is why Microsoft is Microsoft. You know, like, this is a brilliant fucking decision. Boosting communities, as I said, are, in my opinion, bad for the average player. They have a net negative effect on the game. And if something has a net negative effect on the game, why is it in the game? It's actually pretty simple, isn't it? Yeah, why is something in the game if it negatively affects the game?
Yo, I can relate this to Blood Weapon. Why is Blood Weapon in the game if it negatively affects the Dark Knights that play Dark Knight?
So yeah, I don't think this is going to really impact the amount of people buying WoW tokens or anything like that, because people are still going to be selling boosts on their server. It's just cutting down on these massive communities. And the reason why it's cutting down on the massive communities is because these communities are so ripe for exploitation. There's no accountability that these people have that Blizzard can really enforce on them. They can't control what's happening on them. Everybody at Blizzard probably knows that they're doing RMT, but sometimes they can't find it, and so they don't want to ban them. So they just ban the entire practice entirely, and there you go, problem solved. I feel like all the changes today and everything are great. We've got cross-faction raiding, and we've got the removal of the boosting communities to make the game a little bit more authentic. It's a good day to be a WoW player. And we don't get too many of those anymore. And so I'm happy to have it.
True.
That's about it. The newser's baby, setting expectations low. Yeah. I saw somebody, they started... 10.0 was going to be the newser's baby, and they started asking for an abortion. Alright, guys, listen. I gotta go. I gotta drive up to the office, get some dinner or breakfast or lunch, and I want to say thanks everybody for watching, hanging out today. I saw some of these things happen, they're really big news, and I wanted to go live immediately as soon as I could to talk about them.
I'm probably going to be back
in maybe a few hours and stream tonight, talk a little bit more about this stuff, read some of the comments and the malding about it, maybe watch a video talking about the subject as well, but also need to get the videos out for YouTube algorithm, get that shit out real quick. And,
Hell yeah, brother.
So I'll see you guys later. Thanks.
Hell yeah. I should have watched this video like 3 days ago.